We weren't a commercial act. I actually am a rampant snob, and I adored being the critic's darling, and I loved being admired by my peers, and I didn't give a shit really about the hundreds of thousands of records. I really, really didn't.
It has been speculated that this lack of wider success might partly have been due to Richard's songs themselves. Where his lyrics asked the big questions, his answers were often distinctly bleak.
You write a song sometimes from a mood. You don't write a song necessarily, thinking, well, I should take a very balanced view about this topic. You know, you write a song in a fit of emotion. You do push it all the way. You do push it to the limit. But that doesn't mean that's where you live.
I feel for you, your little horror. Say fat to your mother's breast. No lucky break for you around the corner. Cause your father is a bully, and he thinks that you're a pest. And your sister, she's no better than a whore.
I think it's a phenomenal song about a child coming into this crazy world. And it was just after Moona was born, our first child. And I, was kind of pinned to the wall by it. I thought, my God. But again, so many people say to me, were you insulted? It's a terrible song to write about a child. I don't understand that kind of logic.
Life seems so rosy in the cradle. But I'll be a friend, I'll tell you what's in store. There's nothing at the end of the rainbow. There's nothing to grow up for anymore.
Some of his songs go into areas that are almost unthinkable, really. I just hope that in writing such bleak material sometimes it actually helps him, he can sort of ease his burden, because it seems, some of the songs seem so tortuous, the person who made that song must be going through all sorts of anguish to want to do it.
Music is spiritual stuff, it's a very spiritual thing to play music at any level, I believe. I think it's very spiritual stuff, and we have a duty as musicians to explore that side of ourselves. That's a very important thing to do. We've got to look at ourselves and ask ourselves all the time, what we're doing as human beings.
In the mid-1970s, Richard became a Sufi.
Sufism, which is the inside of Islam, it all seemed laid out like a map. If you pray at fixed points, it gives you a certain change of perspective. It keeps you on a certain line as well. You never stray too far from that line, because you have to keep coming back to that line. And that makes life a lot easier. But I don't think there's any conversion. I think you just realize who you are.
Richard became a Muslim, then I became a Muslim. When you go into something like that, you tend to go into it wholeheartedly. And I think we both did. He was, a pain about it. He was very prudish and a pain. But so was I.
Not unusually for the 70s, Richard and Linda, together with their young family, went to live in a commune. Initially, a Sufi community in East Anglia, perhaps not unlike this one in London from the same time.
I didn't like it at all. It was hard going for me. I mean, nobody held a gun to my head, but, you know, in retrospect, I sort of surrendered myself to an insane degree.
Take my hand, oh, real companion, and we'll dance.
When Richard and Linda converted to Sufism, it made quite a difference. They were pretty ascetic at the time, in person. I think, you know, to interviewers and on stage and so on, they were not forthcoming. It wasn't like dealing with Roxy music, for sure.
If you come across something that gives you what you think are the answers, then that has a big impact on what you do, profound impact on what you do. It's probably the most profound impact of anything in my life.
Although Richard practices his faith to this day, he, Linda and their family left the commune after 2 years. The duo gradually re-emerged into the music business world. Their satirical album Sunny Vista was not well received, however. With typical irony, they had their greatest success with what was their last album together, both as a duo and as man and wife.
Having a young family and being on the road was a difficult juggling act. That was something that eventually counted against the marriage.
We were together for, what, 10 years or something, and, you know, it was like 20 years for a normal couple, because we were together during the day and in the evening.
There's a tendency to bring your work home with you and to take home to work. You never get a rest, really. It's non-stop. Difficult situation.
We can't stand the day. Shoot out the light.
People do say that the songs of Shoot Out the Lights are about a disintegrating marriage, but the songs were written a while before the marriage broke up, so I wasn't thinking, oh, look, I've just written a song, this must mean, you know, the marriage is on the rocks because sacre bleu. You know, I think the more you're thinking, well, that's a bit of a dark song, but I quite like it, I'll sing it anyway.
Just watching the dark.
I hate to necessarily associate what's going on in people's lives with how I appreciate their music. The music was already powerful to me. It was pretty clear that something was up or down. It seemed to be tailor-made for the film of them falling apart. You know, it was so sort of spooky. It was breathtaking how accurately it portrayed what was about to happen to them.
During that particular record, I was pregnant and was kind of concentrating on that more than the record. There was soothsaying about all of those songs. When I listened to those songs after the split, I mean, you'd have to be brain dead or 9 months pregnant not to see what was going on, but, you know, I didn't.
When you're rocked on the ocean, rocked up and down, don't worry. When you're spinning and turning round and round, don't worry.
There were a lot of songs about disintegration of relationships, but I was used to those. You know, we sung a lot of those. I sung a lot of those in my time.
Your mind is confused and you can't seem to speak.
He said, I'm in love with somebody else, and left.
It's just the motion. It's just the motion.
The LP, though, became something of a success, especially in America, going on to be voted one of Rolling Stone's top LPs of the 80s. The newly separated Richard and Linda were expected to capitalize on this success and go on tour.